Howdy, everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Your neighborhood druggist feels a responsibility for your health. He is extremely careful in filling your prescription. He uses fine, pure drugs because he knows that to protect your health, he must give you the highest quality. In the same way, your druggist recognizes quality in other items that affect your health. When you see him serving Horlicks malted milk at his fountain, for instance, you know that he is responsible. He is spending a few cents more to give you all the good nourishment of Horlicks. He doesn't serve imitations of Horlicks because he knows that inferior products don't give you the same valuable nourishment that you get in Horlicks. This delicious and satisfying food drink is made only from rich milk with all the cream in it and of the finest wheat and malted barley. When you next go into your drugstore, look for the malted milk dispenser with the Horlicks name. If you don't see it, ask your druggist to get Horlicks, the original malted milk. A good druggist will not substitute. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. Well, Lum was elected president of the new store by a very small majority yesterday. But after finding out that Abner had been urging the public to vote for him, he resigned and gave the office to Abner. So today, the Jot'em Down store opened up under new management. Abner's lifelong ambition has been realized, and he is certainly exercising the authority of the office. As we look in on the Jot'em Down store today, Abner has stepped out for a few moments, and we find Lum and Cedric discussing their new boss. Listen.
Yeah, I ought to know how it'd be if ever he got to be president. Give Abner little authorities and he wants to show out, seems like.
Yes, sir, I bet he's told me 100 times that he's president already.
Yeah, I know when he was first elected constable, he was the same way. Went around arresting everybody he seen. Dug up old laws nobody hadn't thought of in 20 years and started enforcing them.
Yes, sir, I recollect that myself. I know you had my paw locked up in jail down there for nearly a week just for shooting at Jim Blake when they had that fight down there at the blacksmith shop.
Oh, he'd kept me busy dismissing the charges again, fool. Like I told him about your paw there. He never had no ground for locking him up. He shot 6 times at Jim, but he never hit him every time.
No, and that's what made Paul so mad. Said the way Mr. Abner acted, you'd think he'd kill Jim.
Well, I think Abner was just resting folks to be sure everybody knowed he was constable. He don't use no judgment. Like when they had that bank robbery in there at the county seat. Sheriff called out here and said one of the robbers was red-headed, and Granny's Abner arrested every red-headed person in Pine Ridge and locked them up over there in the calaboose. Men, women, and children. And I'm just afeard he's going to be the same way running the store when we get started.
You mean you think he's going to try to arrest everybody?
No, but he's going to try to show his authority. Just look at the signs he's got stuck up around. Sign them all Abner Peabody President. Keep out of the Cracker Barrel and keep out of the showcases. This means you.
Means me?
No, he says this means you. He means whoever's reading the sign.
Well, it's you he's talking about then, ain't it? You're the one that's reading them.
No, he means everybody. He just puts this means you on there so whoever's reading it will know he's talking about them.
Well, I don't see how they'd know he meant it for them if he was talking about me, though.
I told you he weren't talking about you.
Oh, I reckon I never understood you right. I thought you said a minute ago that the sign said it meant me.
No, the sign says this means you, and you is everybody.
When he says me, he means everybody, huh?
He don't say you, he says you, For goodness sake, Cedric, can't you understand nothing? The sign says... Never mind. I wish to goodness you'd learn how to read. You're just going to cause us a batch of trouble here trying to wait on the customer.
Cause some trouble?
Yeah, not knowing how to read, you're liable to give the customer something he never called for. Better let Abner do all the waiting on the trade.
Well, ain't you going to wait on the trade none?
No, I reckon not, Cedric. Sorter makes me dizzy-headed to reach up on the shelves that-a-way. Can't get my arms up no higher in my head no way. See there? Now, Abner can reach clean up over his head like this, but I just can't do it to save my life.
Well, what do you aim to do then, Mr. Lum? You said this morning you couldn't help me stack that feed back there on account of the dust from it bothered your asthma. And...
Oh, no. I can't get around that feed at all. There'll be plenty for me to do. I'll stand up here to the front sorter and speak to the folks nice when they come in. Figure up profits and losses and stuff like that. Study up ideas mostly. You see... Oh, yeah.
What's the matter?
What's this Abner's been writing down here?
Oh, I don't know. He's been working on that there all morning.
Reckon what these initials is for. SDS. Yeah, according to this, Cedric, you're the SDS, whatever that is.
Well, maybe he's pointed me to some office, I bet you.
You got two or three officers here. You're the CF and the FB and WCI.
Well, I reckon I must be his favorite. He said he'd do right by me if he got to be president.
Well, he's give me a couple officers here, I see. The SOU and SOS. SOS. Now, I might not figure out already what that SOS stands for. That's more than likely store overseer.
Yes, Mom, that's about what that is.
Yeah, I knowed he'd have to turn and run in the store over to me. Pretty nice of him, giving me importance job like that. Maybe he ain't going to make such a bad president after all, Cedric. He's got a good idea there, I know that.
Reckon what them officers is he give me there?
Well, I don't know. I'm trying to study out this other of mine. S-O-U. What good that be? I've got an idea that S stands for special. Special. And granted, I don't know what that could be. I'm special something, but I don't know what. Here's some rules he's got down here, too.
Rules?
Yeah, rules to run the store by, I reckon, looks like. He's got, store will open at 6 o'clock sharp. Close at 7 o'clock.
Well, just going to stay open an hour, huh?
Well, no, I reckon he means open at 6 in the morning and close at 7 at night. But he'll get tired of having to get down here at 6 o'clock every morning to open up. That won't last long.
No, he won't keep that up long, I bet you.
Here's another rule. Clerks will have to pay for stuff they eat in the store. Clerks?
Yes, Mom. He told me he's going to do that this morning. Said he's going to put a stop to us running our hand in the candy case every time we pass by it.
Yeah, but he ain't calling me no clerk, is he? I'm a SOS, store overseer. Can't make no rules for me. As long as I've got charge around here, I'll make my own rules.
Oh, yonder he comes back, Mr. Lum. We better get busy.
I ain't going to get busy. I ain't got nothing to do.
Well, you better find something to do then. You know what he said this morning about loafing.
Well, he ain't got no authorities to be bossing the store overseer around. I'll tell him where to get off at.
Hey, you boys, get up from there and get to work.
Boys?
Can I turn my back without you boys just sitting around doing nothing?
Who do you think you're talking to anyway?
Why, I'm talking to both of you. Get up out of the president's chair there. That's my private desk. Just because there ain't no customers in the store here, don't mean that you can just be sitting around. Straighten up them shelves and dust them counters off. Get busy here.
You mean for me to get up and dust off counters?
Why, sure I mean for you to do it. You don't think I'm going to do it, do you?
Well, what about them,
What?
Well, that stuff on the desk there. I just happened to be leaning over there a while ago and sort of got to glancing over it, sort of.
What stuff are you talking about?
Well, that list of them offices and stuff that you find us to.
Oh, well, I weren't ready to say nothing about it yet, but seeing as how you've done meddled into it, I reckon I may as well go ahead and tell you. That's what I call a new deal here at the store.
The new deal?
Yeah, I'm going to start running the store here, sort of like the government's run. We're going to make some changes around here. We're going to have a new deal, yes, sir.
Well, just from what I've seen of it, Abner, I think it's an uncommonly good idea. I know you use good judgment in the office you pointed me to. Now, there's something I can look after, especially that SOS business.
Well, I figured you was a man for the place, huh?
Oh, yeah. Granny's, I'll have things in first-class shape around here.
Well, fine. I'm glad to hear you say that, Mom. I just feared I might have a little trouble with you over there.
Oh, no. You're the president, Abner. Whatever you say goes.
Yeah, that's your time.
Never did figure out that first in there, though, that S-O-U.
Well, come here, Cedric. I'll just give these officers out right now. Here, let me get my spectacles on here. Now, you see what I've did. I've took and divided the store into different departments and appointed you boys head or chairmen of the different departments there.
Oh, you just like the government.
That's the way.
I think that's a good idea.
I couldn't figure out none of them offices you give me, though, Mr. Abner. Couldn't make them out.
Oh, well, now, let's see here. Cedric, you're the SDS.
SDS, right? Yes. I've seen that. Much obliged to you.
Now, SDS means Snappy Deliver Service. That means that you do all the delivering, Cedric.
Well, Cedric, you're a good one for that office, all right. That's a good one.
Yeah, we're going to have some system around here. Everybody know what they're supposed to do and then go and do it.
Yeah, that's the time.
Now, Cedric, you're also the CF.
Well.
That CF is cat feeder.
Oh.
Be short, you set a saucer of milk out for the cat twice today.
Yes, Mom.
And you're the FB, that's fire builder. And WCI, that's the wood carrying.
Well, I do know that. Looks like I got the best of this, don't it? Abner, I'm afraid you're showing partiality, but I ain't holding it against you, so all right.
Well, I'm running.
Now, Cedric, Abner's the president. He's doing this for the good of the store, and we've got to do our part to make it a success.
Yes, sir.
Wood carrier inner.
Now, I reckon that you read the rules there where the store is to be opened up at 6 o'clock every morning.
Yeah, we've seen that. It's a good idea, all right, Abner, if you keep it up. But
well, I'll keep it up, all right. If I come down here and find out that you ain't opened up at 6 o'clock, Lum,
I ain't opened it up.
Yeah, your first office there, Lum, is S-O-U.
Yeah, that's the one I couldn't figure out right there, but I...
Well, now, that S-O-U stands for store opening upper.
You mean it? Well, I'll be dead blamed if I do it.
Huh?
You think the store manager's going to get up at 6 o'clock every morning to open up this store, you just got another guest coming.
Store manager?
Yeah. If you want me to be store manager, you better get somebody else to do that opening
well,
up every morning.
Who said anything about you being a store manager?
Well, I seen it there on the list, S.O.S. I know the minute I looked at it, store overseer is what you meant.
Well, here, Lum, you're the S.O.S., all right, but that stands for sweep out store. Your job is to get down here every morning and have a store swept up and open up here already when I get there.
Well, we don't know, of course, but we're just afraid this new deal won't prove very popular with Lum. Ladies and gentlemen, a lot of you have to work pretty hard all day, no doubt. You just have to keep on your toes. You can't afford to relax, feel drowsy. But I'll bet a lot of you do get a bit tired at times all the same. If you do, here's a tip that may help you to keep on the job. Whenever you feel that drowsy-eyed, fall-asleep feeling coming on, dissolve a couple of Horlick's malted milk tablets in your mouth to help you fight off fatigue. They have all of the energy-giving, sustaining qualities of Horlick's malted milk powder, and they're just as nourishing, too. This is Carlton Brickert, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlick's, who now bid you all good night and good health.